Hey everybody, Sharon here from TheGimmeAct.com. Here we are today back in Killer Queen Black, going for the On Fire achievement. This is to get an economic victory only using throws. This is going to have to be done online. Highly recommend using a boosting partner or friend to help you out with this one, as this achievement is going to be quite challenging. This one's going to be done from the worker side, so make sure you pick that for your class, and then make sure you get into the game. Now, of course, an economic victory is making sure you fill every single one of the 12 slots in your hive with berries. Now, normally you would accomplish this by grabbing one of the many berries on the map and then just walking them in order to bring them to your hive. However, in the case of this achievement, all of these berry slots are going to have to be filled by throwing. So in order to throw a berry, you're going to want to jump and then use the B button to throw. The hitbox on the slots is going to be a little tight once you do the throw, so this achievement is going to be very tricky, and it is going to have to take some pretty precise aim. I'm going to recommend that you try to do this on a map where your hive is going to be in a corner or in a little crevice right here. That way you can take advantage of the walls and corners to try to bounce the berries in. So once you start the game, just make sure you head immediately for the berries. I'm going to recommend that you start with the ones that are closest to your hive. That way you have plenty to work with. You're going to want to stand a reasonable distance away, and then your goal is to try to figure out the arc of the throw. So of course you can get a little boost based on your jump, so make sure you try to calculate that a-okay. The first few throws should be pretty easy since you have a bunch of slots to work with. Just make sure you are super duper careful. Make sure whenever you do have a berry in hand, you want to make sure you stay a reasonable distance away from the hive, as you do not want to accidentally run the berries in, which will void the achievement. So if you do notice the animation of your character coming out of a hive hole, that is going to be what voids the achievement. So make sure you are super careful of dealing with that, especially if you do come off a miss and are trying to rebound the berry for a second chance shot opportunity. So try to work on the most edge case slots first, and if you are playing with a hive that's going to be close to the edge of the screen, make sure you do take advantage of the screen border. So make sure you try to go to the other side and try to throw it through the screen in order to try to get that right distance. This is going to take a lot of patience, as again, those hitboxes are going to be super duper tight. So just make sure you take your time and make sure you get those arcs right, and then you should be able to fill in the slots slowly but eventually. Of course, just like every other achievement in this game, this one's going to be way more manageable if you're doing this with a boosting partner or friend, so make sure you have both of you bring 4 controllers each, and that way you can fill up all of the slots. And thankfully, in that situation, you should be able to have more than enough time to work on this, as you don't have a bunch of people trying to go for the other objectives or trying to interrupt us as we're trying to line up our shots. So once you take care of those edge-most slots, we can start working on the ones that are closer to the middle. So again, with these ones, I'm going to recommend that you play on a map with a corner. That way you can get some good bounces off. You want to be a little careful if you're playing on a map that has the two hives close to one another. The reason for that is if you do throw a berry, if it does hit your opponent's hive, you can accidentally fill in their slots. So if you have too many of those mistakes in a row, that might accidentally cost you the game. So make sure you be mindful and be super careful in those scenarios. But if you are doing this in a boosting game, you shouldn't worry too much about that, since you don't have anyone who is going to be actively trying to fill up all of your opponent's slots. Just make sure you're careful with that. Even on a game like this, where they're going to be the back walls that are going to be open, a bad bounce can accidentally end up with you scoring on yourself. So make sure you are super mindful of those spots. So once we are down to the last couple of slots or so, the shots are going to end up being a little trickier, so make sure you try to work on those bounce shots as well as those mid-air shots. Make sure you're trying to get the arc of your jumps right, and make sure you're trying to get those shots curved in just perfectly, and then we should be able to whittle this down. Again, this is going to be an achievement that takes a lot of patience in order to get this, even if you are boosting it. So just make sure you take your time, and then make sure you don't get too frustrated with the complexity of the shots as you get deeper into the game. So here we are on our last berry. We're going to go for our last shot for the win. Make sure you try to get it off, and then once you bounce it in, you should take home the victory. You should be good for 2 achievements. First one is going to be nice throw. That's just for scoring a single shot with a throw. That one's going to be for 10 gamer score. But if we do manage to get all 12 in a single game and win the round like this, we should be good for the big one, On Fire, for a hefty 100 gamer score. And that's all there is to it.